Probably among the biggest two words in medicine right now are minimally invasive. Those are surgical procedures that use special instruments and create less trauma. Boca Raton Regional Hospital now has advanced technology in this field that's changing the standards of how many of these operations are done. Dr. Frank Sarasano of Boca Raton Regional Hospital is here to explain more. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Marcia.
For those who don't know, what is minimally invasive? How does it compare to traditional surgery?
Minimally invasive surgery really characterizes surgery through very small incisions that doctors can use for the right hand, the left hand, and instruments that allow them to conduct the surgery without actually having to open the abdomen.
Okay. Now, Boca Raton Regional Hospital recently acquired a new robotic system that they're saying actually is an improvement over minimally invasive. What is it and how does it work?
Sure. The Da Vinci robotic system actually is a mechanism to extend the physician's ability. In conventional laparoscopy, the right hand and the left hand instruments are controlled by the surgeon. With robotic surgery, the right hand and the left hand instruments are actually controlled by the robot, which is then controlled by the surgeon at a console. Very similar to a video game or a simulator to accomplish the same goals in surgery.
Now, you'd think that during a surgery, the surgeon would need to feel how the body is responding. Does this give any kind of feedback to the surgeon?
In actuality, after about 35 to 50 cases with subsequent training, the surgeon can actually develop a fine motor sense that the robotic system will provide. In many ways, the vibratory sensation and tactile stimulation that can be acquired with conventional laparoscopy can also be acquired with robotic surgery.
So what type of procedures are we talking about that you're able to do with this system?
Well, the dominant procedure currently used for the robotic Da Vinci S system is actually GYN surgeries such as a hysterectomy.
Okay.
Hysterectomy with the ovaries or without the ovaries has been the primary procedure applied.
Any drawbacks to using the robotic system?
Well, the drawbacks, I think, play a role in limiting the number of surgeons that actually use the device because it does take some training and experience.
Yeah, what is involved in the training? How much training are these surgeons getting?
Well, at the current time, training programs are starting to introduce robotic surgery to residencies and to internships so that the surgeons that are coming out today are starting to be introduced to these robotic technologies as part of their program.
Now, this is a million-dollar machine. Does insurance cover these kinds of procedures?
The indications for the surgery stay the same. Whether the uterus has to be removed or whether or not the ovary has to be removed really depends on the type of tumor there is and the dimensions of the tumor. Whether or not the surgeon chooses to use conventional laparoscopy, robotic laparoscopy, or a classic incision is really dependent upon the surgeon's comfort level.
Okay, thank you so much. Boca Raton Regional Hospital sponsors our expert and underwrites our Ask the Doctor feature.